everybody. Thanks for joining us on this Sunday morning. Let's go ahead and just jump right into it. Let's have some fun as we prepare ourselves for this Palm Sunday, this very unique and this very special Palm Sunday. So let's go. And now, a How Not game in collaboration with Randomness with Wren.
Oh, why hello there. You caught me reading. Welcome to Masterpiece Theatre. Grab your cup of tea and sit back. It's now time for Randomness with Wren.
Begin by getting your broom. Then put on your roller skates and roll up one of your leg pants. Begin to sweep your floor. Feel free to put obstacles in your way, like a random hardback baby book. Congratulations, if you've stayed on your feet and have swept the floor, you have won. I don't know what you've won, but congratulations for being random. This has been a How Not game. Thank you for joining us. Let's turn our attention to our scripture. Be still before the Lord and wait patiently for him. Do not fret when people succeed in their ways, when they carry out their wicked schemes. Psalm 37, verse 7. Keep practicing on memorizing it, and don't forget to memorize the address as well. Let's sing together now with Tyler Murphy, the song, We Come.
Come teach yourself your unrelenting love. Open our eyes to see your heart for us. And we are here to meet with our Creator. To know the Lord is God and we are His. We King above all gods, in your presence, Lord, we are found and we are loved. We come and we come. The sound of joyful praise in unison. Grateful hearts rejoice in all you've done. We kneel before the King, the Eternal. For you alone, our God, there is no other. And we come. And we come. Great King above all gods, in your presence, Lord, and we are found and we are loved, and you are Lord of lords, a great King above all gods, and in your presence, Lord, and we are found and we are loved, and we and we come, and we come, our desire is you. We come, and fill our hearts with your truth. And we come, and our desire is you. We come. And fill our hearts with your truth. We sing it again. We come. And our desire is you. weaker, and fill our hearts with your truth. Yes, we come, for our desire is you, and we come, Lord, and fill our hearts with your truth, 'cause you are Lord of lords, a great King above all gods. In your presence, Lord, and we are found and we are loved. Yes, you are Lord of lords, and a great King above all gods. And in your presence, Lord, and we are found and we are loved. So we come, Lord, we come. Gods, in your presence, Lord, and we are found and we are loved. Yes, you are Lord of lords, a great King above all gods. In your presence, Lord, and we are found and we are loved. So we come, and we
Well, welcome to this very special and unique Palm Sunday as we are preparing for Resurrection Sunday, as we also call Easter. And this morning I'd like to read from Matthew chapter 21. Matthew 21 contains our passage about Palm Sunday. In Matthew 21 it says, as they approached Jerusalem, meaning Jesus and his disciples, they came to Bethphage on the Mount of Olives. Jesus sent two disciples, saying to them, go to the village ahead of you, and at once you will find a donkey tied there with her colt by her. Untie them and bring them to me. If anyone says anything to you, say that the Lord needs them, and he will send them right away. This took place to fulfill what was spoken through the prophet. Say to daughter Zion, see, your king comes to you, gentle and riding on a donkey, and on a colt, the foal of a donkey. The disciples went and did as Jesus had instructed them. They brought the donkey and the colt and placed their cloaks on them for Jesus to sit on. A very large crowd spread their cloaks on the road, while others cut branches from the trees and spread them on the road. The crowds that went ahead of him and those that followed shouted, Hosanna to the Son of David. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest heaven. When Jesus entered Jerusalem, the whole city was stirred and asked, who is this? And the crowds answered, this is Jesus, the prophet from Galilee. I want to encourage you this morning as we study that you stick through to the end, that you challenge yourself to stick with it as we study through Matthew 21, to not skip ahead, to not cut it out, but to walk through it as we prepare ourselves for what is also known as the Holy Week. Let's pray as we study together briefly this morning. Lord, we thank you so much for your word. We ask you right now to still our hearts. Lord, to remember that every breath that we breathe comes from you, and to find your presence in the words. In your Son Jesus' name we pray. Amen. As we look at the passage, Jesus knows what's coming. He is in preparation for what is coming. He came to be with us for this purpose. As Jesus gets ready to enter into Jerusalem as he is preparing for his own betrayal and death. He is trusting in God. And the story starts with a donkey. And Jesus being king of the universe, you would naturally assume he would come on a horse. But you see, the symbolism of a horse was a symbol of war. Jesus was coming into Jerusalem in peace. And the people threw a party. They were excited about him coming. Perhaps he will be the Savior. And maybe they misunderstood what kind of Savior he would be. Maybe they assumed that he was going to be a great king that would overthrow the Romans, as we see. Sometimes we make assumptions of who Jesus is as well. Sometimes we make assumptions as well about who others are going to be, people we look up to, people that we consider role models, leaders in our lives, adults, people that we look up to. And you know what? They let us down, because sometimes we see them as larger than life, as we see these people, and they make mistakes because they're human beings, and they let us down. They're not who we thought they would be. And sometimes we get angry, we turn on them, we treat them ugly, when sometimes it was our own assumptions that we made. You see, Jesus came into Jerusalem riding a donkey in symbolism. He was showing who he was from the very beginning, from his birth. The tone was set for who was going to be. He was born into a feeding trough. He was born into the city of called the House of Bread, Bethlehem. He was wrapped in linens that are made reference as being like death linens. There was no place for him, no home for him. And then soon after, his life was spent on the run. He would be the bread of life that would give life to all. But he didn't, and he was not born into a royal household. And as he comes into Jerusalem, he comes in triumph and in victory as the people shout and cheer. But he does not come on a horse. He comes in, as we said, on a donkey. As a symbol of peace, as a symbol of lowliness, not as a symbol of war. For he's coming to bring peace. The same that was heralded at his birth to the shepherds by the angels. And so as Jesus rides in, the people cut branches and they took these palm leaves and they spread them down, it says, on the ground. The crowd shouted, "Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord." We see that reference out of Psalms 118, 25 and 26, if you want to do some little homework and read that later. They shouted, "Hosanna," which means like save me, or save, or for help me, to the Son of David. They recognized that he was a descendant of David. Maybe he would be this Messiah that would sit upon David's throne as the king. They called on help from the highest heavens. The whole city was stirred and they asked, "Who is this?" The crowds answered, "This is Jesus, the prophet from Nazareth in Galilee." Sometime later, I want you to read Zechariah 9:9 in reference to the donkey and the prophecy that was read there in Matthew 21. You can find the story in the other Gospels as well, with other references and other details. But for this morning, I want you to take note and I want you to ask, first of all, the question of who is Jesus to you? Because on Palm Sunday, he's a king, he's riding into town. The people are making an assumption, possibly, of what he's going to do. And within just a very short period of time, they turn on him and they choose a criminal over him. They shout for him to be crucified when just a few days prior they were shouting, "Save us." How quickly things can turn. So I want you to ask yourself, who is Jesus to you today? I want you to consider that. And what we're going to do is I've got a project for you today. I want you to get a piece of paper and I want you to draw a palm leaf upon it or a palm branch. You could color it, you can design it, you can do several of them if you want. And what I want you to do is if you want to cut it out, and I want you to put it on one of the front windows of your house as we celebrate Palm Sunday. And I want you to leave it there all week long. Within a few days, on Thursday, it was the celebration of the Last Supper of Jesus. On Friday is the celebration that's called Good Friday, where they celebrate and remember the death of Jesus and why it's so centrally important. And then next Sunday is Resurrection Sunday. So we celebrate Jesus rising from the dead. And that is so important because if there was no resurrection, everything else is meaningless. So as we close this morning, spend some time today and ask yourself, who is Jesus to you? And you know what? What we might find is that some of the ideas that we have about Jesus aren't true. They're just not real. And if you go start thinking about who is Jesus to you and you come up with all of these different ideas, write them down. And you can check yourself on them, because sometimes what happens over time is we make up all of these different ideas about who Jesus is. But we don't know where we get these ideas from. They build from little specks here and little specks here. And suddenly we have this Jesus who isn't actually the real Jesus, or the authentic Jesus, as we like to say at C4. So who is the real Jesus? We're going to talk about this week as we're talking about not only the stillness and trusting in him and waiting upon him. There was a lot of trepidation that was going on this week in Jerusalem in those moments. A lot of uncertainty from his disciples as that Last Supper came. And Jesus told them, "I'm going away and you can't go where I'm going," as he was arrested. Who is Jesus to you? Maybe on days when he is the Jesus that you want, he is the Jesus that you imagined, and he is the Jesus that is letting you do what you want to do and giving you what you want, that's the Jesus we want. But what happens when he's the Jesus that becomes the slave in front of us and washes our feet and allows himself to be arrested and beaten? And we feel like we just guess we didn't know Jesus at all. And we take that pause and that breath. So who is Jesus to you? Let's ask ourselves that this morning. So go ahead, work on your project with your palm leaves this morning. Work on it with your younger siblings. And let's enjoy this Palm Sunday as we prepare for Easter. I'll see y'all later, guys. Make sure to comment or send me things if you have any questions. See y'all later. I want to take a moment before we close out the video. And I want to remember just a few prayer requests. I want to remember Mr. Roy's wife, Jackie. Of course, they still can't have a memorial service for him due to everything going on. I want to remember Gabe's grandma, of course, Miss Carla, and his grandpa, Mr. Dave. She's, of course, in the hospital, and because of it, Mr. Dave can't go see her. And I know there's lots of other prayer requests and things that are going on right now with everybody. So feel free to update me with the prayer requests, and we'll be praying over those. I know a lot of y'all have been stuck inside your house for a while, and that starts to get a little tiring, I know. Get a little squirmy, and it gets a little boring at times. But I want to encourage you to be Jesus to those in your house. Remember, don't be that person that is not like Jesus, but be Jesus to those around you. So we'll pray for that. And so let's close this time together with prayer. Lord, today we thank you for Mr. Roy once again. We thank you for the influence he's had on everybody. We ask you to be with Miss Jackie and everybody who is in his life. We ask you to comfort them and give them peace. We ask you to be with Miss Carla. Please continue to make her feel better and to get healthy. We ask that your will be done over the situation. We ask you that Mr. Dave can be comforted and have peace during this time of difficulty. Give him strength. I ask you also to be with Gabe as well, as he's going through this time with his grandmother being sick. Lord, I remember everybody. We ask you to help us to be more like you, bring us encouragement, and help us to have peace. In your son Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Good morning, guys. See y'all later.